The bushfire season is here, and the New South Wales Rural Fire Service is showing off their latest water bombers and aerial firefighting equipment.
What you see today is the next generation. This is the sort of technology and capability that 10 years ago we only dreamt about.
The New South Wales government will spend $192 million on nighttime aerial firefighting, new equipment, and better mental health support for emergency services.
Aircraft don't put out fires, firefighters on the ground put out the fires, but this gives an enormous capability to try and slow these fires down and make it safer, particularly where you get those fires that start in remote areas, lightning strikes, where we can winch firefighters into those fires and put them out, whereas otherwise you just have to wait until that fire came out.
It's the largest aerial fleet of any fire agency in Australia, including a large air tanker, helicopters and Citation Bird Dog aircraft.
So this is a Bell 412 helicopter. It carries more water, it carries more firefighters. It also has this camera on it, which can take real-time video footage of fires and also at night. So we can then send that image to our local fire control centres so that they can see exactly what is going on with these fires. The other things they can do is we can winch people into fires, which winch people that are trapped out of fires.
The last bushfire season was unprecedented and catastrophic. Almost 2,500 homes were destroyed, 5.5 million hectares burnt, 25 people lost their lives, and billions of animals perished.
Some 51 people were rescued from fire areas during last summer, either on RFS or military aircraft manned by RFS. So this sort of capability, it actually saves lives.
The $51 million from Celeste Barber's Bushfire Fund did not contribute to this investment.
That money we want to see go to the benefit of actually firefighters on the ground. So the type of things we're using that money for, accelerating rollout of a new generation of fire helmets. Local brigades have put in bids of what they want to do in their local area, making their own stations better, different equipment they need.
An independent bushfire inquiry established during the horror season in January handed down 76 recommendations in July. The inquiry recommended landowners across New South Wales be obliged to conduct more hazard reduction burns on their properties. The RFS hopes the investment will help avoid a repeat of last summer's horror bushfire season.
There is a level of reassurance that they've never had before. And I think that the capability to identify fires early, to extinguish fires early, the capability to evacuate people in danger, the capability to deploy ground troops at short notice and under difficult conditions and terrain now is just made that little bit easier.